everybody, welcome to the Wall Dock Way. I'm Jessica, and today's video is going to be what we got Emily for Christmas. So Emily is a 9-year-old girl. This is going to include her stocking as well as everything that will be under the tree Christmas morning. So if you know Emily in real life, please don't tell her what you're about to see because obviously we want all of this to be a surprise. But we're really hoping to maybe inspire you, give you some ideas, or well, just let you have a peek into our life. So I'm gonna start with her stocking. I will link the stocking if you like it. We ordered them off of Amazon last year. We all have matching ones with our names on them. And inside her stocking, we have two Our Generation, like the small little kits. This one is an I Love Math kit. We get these from Target. It's the Math Whiz. And then this one is the Around the World. Emily absolutely loves playing school with her American Girl dolls, so I thought this would be a fun addition. She will get, you know, math and geography. So, plus, you know, the homeschool mom and me loves that. She also has in here a new set of books. This is called Dragon Girls. There are 6 books currently in the series. I researched for a new series for her for forever, and this one looked really fun. It looked like something she would love. The summary on the back of the first one is, as Mina, Willa, and Naomi are thrilled to learn their glitter dragon girls, summoned to the magic forest by its magnificent ruler, the Tree Queen. The girls quickly find out their dragon selves have unbelievable abilities. They can soar above the treetops, breathe glittery bursts of fire, and roar loud enough to shake the ground. Seriously, girls, dragons, glitters, magic, what's not to love for her? So I got her that set. She has a Erin's Thinking Putty. We love these. We keep them in the car. We keep them in my purse. She keeps them in her backpack all over the place. But I found a scented one. So this is the sensory putty that is scented Jam Session. And then down in the bottom, we have a few games. The first game we have is Trash Pandas, the Rackus Raccoon card game. And then the new Unstable Unicorns for kids. So that's what's in her stocking. We will probably also throw a few pieces of candy in there. Her favorite are Reese's, so we'll probably get her some Reese Christmas trees. Obviously, I'm not going to store chocolate, though, so that is what's in her stocking. Okay, next is going to be her gifts. Now, let me go ahead and preface this by saying, if you did not watch my gift guides and my holiday hauls, I'm a themed gift giver, which means I normally bundle most of Emily's gifts, and you're gonna see that. So I'm giving you a heads up ahead of time. Also, when we went to see Santa, if you follow me on Instagram, you already know this. If you don't, I'm gonna tell you. When we went to see Santa last week, I thought I knew what Emily was going to ask for. I had already bought it. She's been asking for it since last Christmas when a friend of hers got it, but she surprised me and she did not ask for the camera I thought she was going to ask for. Instead, she asked Santa for a dolphin because she has been so worried about winter since, or about Hope since winter passed away at Clearwater Marine Aquarium. She wanted Santa to bring her a dolphin for Clearwater Marine Aquarium. So basically she wants Hope to have a new friend. I stood there crying, but obviously we cannot buy her a dolphin. So what we did instead is we are giving her the Wild Adventure Vet book, which is absolutely gorgeous, along with this Polly Pocket Vet Ultimate Pet Care set that we found. It's like the ambulance, the pet care. It's got all of the things in it. She's really been into the Polly Pocket show on Netflix lately. So we thought she would really, really like playing with that. And again, it's vet. So we are going to give her these two vet things with a note that we will visit Clearwater Marine Aquarium. So we're going to be giving her that as an experience and that we will make whatever kind of donation they see fit. So I have reached out to them by email and I haven't got a response yet. And we just want to kind of know the best way to help. So if that's monetary, then that's what we'll do. If it's volunteering, that's what we'll do. But we just wanted to make it clear to her that we heard her and that we will be doing that. But I also wanted her to have a gift. So we're going to give her the vet book with the Polly Pocket vet set to play with a note that we will visit Clearwater Marine Aquarium and donate in whatever way they think will best fit them. So that is kind of like her big gift because she surprised me. Her big gift was supposed to be, and she will still get it, the Intax mini camera. She had a friend get one last year for Christmas and she begged and begged and begged me for it. As a photographer who has literally three really nice expensive cameras that she has access to, I originally was like, I'm not buying that for you. But she's continued to beg for it all year long. She likes that the stuff would be printed instantly. And so I thought, why not? It will help her see what she's taking a picture of a little bit quicker because it prints out. She'll get that instant satisfaction. And who knows what kind of interest it could spark. And then if she does end up loving it, again, I have tons of really nice kind of expensive cameras that she can grow into or use when she's ready. So in that, we bought the bundle. It's the mini camera, the camera case, and then like a little photo album, and quite a few things of film. Sorry. There we go. So that is the bundle that we bought her. And I'm sure she will still love it, even though it's not what she ended up asking Santa for in the end. Okay, a book set. This is a book series that she's absolutely loved. We have checked out these four first ones from the library a dozen times, and I thought it would just be fantastic to add it to our collection. So we have Iggy Peck Architect, Rosie Revere Engineer, Ada Twist Scientist. And this is the one that made me want to go ahead and buy the picture book set for her because she's been watching Ada Twist Scientist on Netflix. She's watched all of them multiple times. And she's like, Mom, why don't we have the picture books? Isn't that what we read first? Because she has the chapter books. So I went back and bought these for her. And then Sophia Valdez for Future Prez. And then they just released a brand new one into the series. And so I went ahead and grabbed that too. And that's Aaron Slater, Illustrator. Now, with these books, I got her a new science kit from National Geographic. If you've been around here a while, you know we love them. They're her and Kevin's favorite, and they do some sort of science activity once a week. But of course, it had a shipping delay, so it is not here yet. So I'm going to show you a picture, and it is the National Geographic electricity and battery kit. Emily's been begging to do the potato alarm clock, electricity type thing or lemon or whatever. So when I saw that and I knew that we were getting her the questionnaire set, it just seemed like the perfect bundle. So that will be all in one box or bag together. And then when I saw that I was getting her the Aaron Slater Illustrator, I knew, like, you know how you can just, you know your kid and you know that there's certain things that are going to spark an interest. That's going to spark an interest for her. She has a dad who's an artist. She loves to draw. So when she reads the Illustrator book, the first thing she's going to want to do is write a book so that she can illustrate it. So when I saw these on Usborne, I knew that they would be perfect. And they are a Illustrate This Book series. So the book is written and they need your help to illustrate them. So we have the unicorn party, my prehistoric pet, and one brave astronaut. All three of those are topics that she really, really likes. She loves unicorns, dinosaurs, and all things space. So she will be thrilled to do that. And then I got her a set of the Studliner pens, just like Daddy. So he has a set of these. They're permanent, so we haven't been huge, you know, on letting her have them in the past. They're a little expensive, but she loves them. She knows that Daddy uses them, so she's going to be thrilled to have some just like Daddy. So that will be that gift bundle. See, I told you I like themed gifts, right? Okay, next we have some human body stuff. Another thing that she's been very interested in lately, so I thought we would get her some things to kind of see where that goes. I picked up Organ Attack a few months back and saved it. So that will be bundled with 3 of the Dr. Livingston anatomy puzzles. So there are 7 total puzzles to form the whole body. I just got her the first 3 to see how we felt about them. So we have the head, which is volume 1. We have the thorax, which is volume 2. And we have the abdomen, which is volume 3. So again, that will all be bundled together. And then the last thing I specifically bought for her was this pottery studio. It's a pottery studio junior, and it has everything that you need. She has been watching. She likes to look over my shoulder when I'm doing when I'm watching Instagram stories. And my girl Abby from Rooted and Rest, their kids do a pottery class, or at least they have been doing one lately. And every time she sees them doing pottery in my stories, she's like, "Mom, I would really like to do that. Can you find me a pottery class?" Which, honestly, I haven't had the chance to even look into yet. So when I saw this, I'm like, you know what? This is perfect. This gives her the ability to kind of see if she likes it, if she likes it, if it's something she enjoys doing. Obviously, she's got the gift to keep doing it. And then I can get her classes maybe for, you know, in the future, her birthday, or enroll her in something to let her kind of explore that deeper. So I'm hoping that this will spark an interest. We'll see. Okay, and then there's 2 more things that I wanted to tell you about because they're not necessarily her gifts, but it's something that we do and that she'll be getting anyway. The first of which is a family gift. So we do a family gift for our gift every year. It's something that we've done forever, I think. It's normally passes to somewhere. In the past, it's been our Disney annual passes. Last year, we bought a laser tag set, which was amazing. We had so much fun with it because there wasn't a lot of places that you could go. This year, we would have bought our Universal passes, obviously, but we got those in September so that we could be, you know, at Universal for the first day of Harry Potter. So that is what we would have done for our family gift. And because that was a pricier family gift, we needed something that was a little bit more affordable as a Christmas gift. So we got a few new games because we love games. Family game nights are something we do every week. And we have really been enjoying tile laying games lately. We have fallen in love with a game called Patchwork, and there's just a few other ones that we really like that are like tile laying. So I did some digging and found 3 kind of interesting tile type laying games that our family is now interested in to gift us this year. So that's the family gift, and it will be Aqualyn, which is schooled or get schooled. It's getting pretty crowded here in the reef. Soon it will be packed to the gills with sea creatures. Before it fills up completely, you have to match as many as you can by laying these tiles. So that's one. Now that's a 2-player. I specifically got that because me and Emily play a lot of games by ourselves. So I like having a 2-player game, or even her and Kevin, because there's only 3 of us, because we're homeschooling an only child. It's very often that only one parent is playing with her. So I do like to try to add a 2-player game when we can. And so that one is just a 2-player game. Just so you know, if you have a big family, that might not be the perfect fit for you. This one, I know Emily's going to go gaga for. It's called Calico. It's a spatial puzzle game for the whole family. Players are quilters completing to create the coziest, most beautiful quilts. So you are drawing the pieces and trying to create your quilt for your cat. And she's obsessed with cats, so she's going to love that one. And then the last one is Azul. I've had this on my wish list forever. I literally look at it every time we go on Barnes & Noble's, and it went on sale on Black Friday, and so I grabbed it quickly. Azul invites you, a tile laying artist, to embellish the walls of the Royal Palace of Evora. And it is just gorgeous. Like, the pieces of the game are so beautiful. The last thing that I have is probably kind of silly. Last year we did a Holidays Around the World, and somehow on our Holidays Around the World study, Emily learned about the tradition where you hide a pickle ornament or a pickle on the Christmas tree, and whoever finds it gets a gift. So then this year when we were in Target, she found a pickle ornament and commenced to talking me into buying it and wanted to hide it on the tree and see who finds it. So obviously, since there's just the 3 of us, one of the 3 of us is going to find the pickle ornament on the tree. So I thought it would be super funny if whoever found the pickle ornament actually got a pickle. So this is a game that is called In a Pickle by Game Right. We love Game Right games, so I know it's going to be a hilarious game. But it actually comes in a plastic pickle. It is kind of a creative wordplay game. So for instance, on the back, they have an example. The word baby can be in a bathtub, can be in a house, can be in Hollywood. So it's kind of a word game, and you have to try to talk the other players into, you know, why your word can be in that one, like why it can go in it, which I just thought would be a fun, you know, game in general for our family. And it can be played with as little as two players, which any game that can be played with that few players is always a win in our house. So that's it. That is what will be under our Christmas tree or in her stocking this year. And now I would love it if you would give me ideas. So what are you getting your kids? What's on their wish list? What's, you know, something that your 9-year-old is desiring this year? Because while I don't need ideas for this Christmas, I'm sure everybody else can use even more ideas. And I would love to create an idea bank in the comments. So please let me know.